What's up, everyone? I'm Lucy, and you're watching the Edit With Me Monday show. And today, we're talking all about the lens correction panel in Lightroom and how you can use it to really perfect your photo. So let's jump right in. All right, so we're here in Lightroom and you can find the lens correction panel just on the right side here. So just click that little arrow to expand it and we can see what we're working with. So I just have my photo here. This is one of me and my friend Lizzie. We're just chilling out at a Fairmont hotel. It was actually pretty nice. My friend Chris took the photo. We were out of town for a project and we always like to just do some fun photos when we're doing stuff for work as well. So I'm gonna take this photo and do some lens correction to it. Now the first thing I wanna mention is that this was taken on a 16 to 35 millimeter and while the fisheye sort of effect on that isn't drastic, it is there a little bit. And on this photo, a really easy place you can see it is up in this molding. See how that's not a straight line, it's actually warped. And that is because the warping from the lens. Every lens has some kind of distortion to it. Nothing is 100% perfect. So when we go into lens corrections, we can go and fix those. So first I'm gonna just show you, if you were just to go click enable profile corrections, what that does is Lightroom's gonna figure out what lens this shot was taken with. It's super smart, so it knows, and it'll actually apply custom profile corrections to just fix that distortion. So if I just went before, after, you can see it did a pretty good job. That molding there is looking pretty straight. Everything in the middle of the frame kind of got a little bit smaller and the vignetting went away. So 9 times out of 10, that's gonna work pretty well for you. Maybe if you're using an adapter or something like that on your camera, this won't be able to figure out what your lens is, but that's okay. We can go in manually and fix that. Before we jump into manual though, I'm gonna show you one more one-click kind of fix that you can do, and that's with chromatic aberration. I would always do this on your photos because again, that's just another little thing that happens with distortion. It's basically like fringing. And so if I zoom in over here, you can see on the edge of this bed, this sort of like weird blue color that like, there's no reason why that would need to be there. So if I click that button there, it did a pretty good job. It's almost completely gone. So that's awesome. So I would always suggest on your photos, go to lens correction, click those two buttons, and you're gonna be good to go. But for the sake of this tutorial, we're gonna go into the manual, see what we can do there. So I'm gonna unclick both of these, and now let's go over to manual. So in manual, basically, we can do that distortion, we can just fix it to our own liking. So again, I'm using this as sort of the barometer of how distorted it is, so we'll just move it over until that looks straight. Right around there, we're looking pretty good. The other thing I really like about this, and you could do this on portraits too, is that it actually makes whatever is in the center of your photo look smaller and everything else around it look a bit bigger. So you can see me and Lizzie actually, you know, we look a bit smaller there. It's a little bit flattering. So play with that. Now you can see if I did too much, now we're going into distorting that molding the other way. So just be careful on that. If there's nothing actually a straight line to show it, you have a lot more leeway. But in this photo, we kind of have a point at which we have to cap it. So now we're in that defringe, and this is basically that chromatic aberration thing. So if we're in here, we can see that bluey kind of thing again. So fringing is usually gonna be on a purple or green spectrum. Here it's green. So what I'm gonna do is just bring up that, and we took a lot of it away. But also when we did it in auto, we still had a bit of the blue. So we're just gonna change that range and get that to include blue as well. And now that's pretty perfect. Now, depending on your lens, the fringing you have might be more of a purplish blue. I find a lot of the time with landscapes and shots of trees, usually you get that purple fringing in the branches. So this is a really, really easy way to go in and just get rid of that. And then the last thing in manual is that vignetting. Again, all lenses have some kind of vignetting. Some are lighter, some are darker. So here we can see it's actually quite dark in and around there. I'd really like to lighten that up. Change around the midpoint a little bit to your own liking. That looks pretty great. So there you go. That's how you do lens correction in Lightroom. It is such a simple tool, but really just doing a few tweaks in lens correction can totally perfect your photo and make it look really, really professional. As always, if you guys like this tutorial, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell, and leave me a comment on what you'd like me to talk about next time. All right, guys, we'll see you soon. Peace out.